ओके okay. गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वेलकम द ऑल स्टूडेंट इन द ब्रू मुंबई म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ऑनलाइन टीचिंग प्रोग्राम. टुडे इज द 31st August 2020. आई एम स्वप्निल पाटिल फॉर द टुडे सेशन. सो वी विल सी द मैथ सब्जेक्ट इन द टुडे सेशन एंड वी नो दैट एज पर आवर शेड्यूल टुडेज टॉपिक इज डेसिमल फ्रैक्शन. बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द डेसिमल फ्रैक्शन we will recall the about the previous lesson. Which is the previous lesson? The previous lesson is the fraction. So we will see the fraction. What is a fraction? So first of all, we will see the definition of fraction. Look at here. What is a fraction? A number representing part of a whole, usually written as the ratio of numerator and non-zero denominator. Means the fraction we have to return in the form of ratio. There is a one numerator and second digit is the denominator. If we will write the a by b or a upon b, here a is the numerator and b is the denominator. There are some example of fraction. 1 by 2, 1 is the numerator and 2 is the denominator. Again, the same example, 3 by 4. 3 is the numerator and 4 is the denominator. Third example, 7 by 4. 7 is the numerator and 4 is the denominator. We had already learned this in the previous lesson and previous lecture also. So now we will see the some top types of fraction. There are the three types of fraction. We will see this. First type, proper fraction, improper fraction, and third one is the mixed fraction. First type of fraction, proper fraction. A fraction has numerator is less than its denominator. We will see the example in the next picture. First of all, we will see the definition. Proper fraction, a fraction has numerator is less than its denominator. Means which fraction has the numerator in the above side and the denominator in the downward side. Means smaller number in the above side and the greater number in the downward side. Now the second fraction, improper fraction. A fraction has numerator is greater than its denominator. The second type of fraction, improper fraction. A fraction has numerator is greater than its denominator. Means the smaller number in the denominator, means in the downward side, and the greater number in the upward side. The third one is the mixed fraction. Mixed fraction means we know the meaning of mix. Means the two object or two thing in the get together or together. It's a mix. So how to we find the mixed fraction? See the definition of mixed fraction. When an improper fraction is written as a combination of whole number and the proper fraction. There are the two numbers are there. One is the whole number and second one is the proper fraction. So we will see the example of these three types of fraction. First of all, proper fraction. Numerator is smaller than its denominator. Look at here in the example, 1 by 3. 1 is the smaller than 3. Means the denominator is the 3, 1 is the numerator. Means 1 is the smaller than 3. So our definition is there, numerator is smaller than. Means numerator of course is smaller than denominator. In the second example, 5 by 8. Five smaller than 8. So numerator is smaller than denominator. Second type of fraction, numerator is larger than its denominator. In the improper fraction, numerator is larger than its denominator. Here, look at here. 7 by 3. 7 is larger than 3. Means numerator is larger than denominator. Second example, 4 by 3. 4 is greater than 3. So, as per our definition, some examples are there. 7/3 and the 4/3. Now the mixed fraction. What is the definition of mixed fraction? The combination of whole number and proper fraction. Combination of whole number and proper fraction. So here, look at what is this example? 3 integer 5/7. What is this example? 3 integer 5/7. In this example, 3 is the whole number and 5/7 is the proper fraction. In the second example, also same. 2 integer 4/9. 4 is the whole number and 4/9 is the proper fraction. So these are the types of fraction we had already learned in the previous lecture. Now we will see the today's topic. Our today's topic is the decimal fraction. Do you know that what is a decimal fraction? Look at here. When we divide the number to use the decimal point, look at here. The one chart is there. First of all, we will see the number. What number is there? 6945.3728. What is the number? 6945.3728. We call or we read this digit like this, 3728, not like this, 3728. We read this 3728. Okay, look at here. One decimal point is there. This is a decimal point. Okay, after the decimal point on the right hand side, these are the decimal fraction number 3728. These are the decimal fraction number. And before the decimal point or beside the left side, these are the whole number. Okay, 6945. It is a whole number. So we will see the places of this digit. First of all, decimal fraction. We will see the decimal fraction. And beside the left side of decimal fraction, first place is the one. On the ones, which number is there? 5. Second place, 10. Third one place, 100. Here the 9. What is the place value of 9? 900. Okay. Place of 4. 4 tens means 40. 5 ones means 5. Now, last place, 1000. What is last place? 1000. After 1000, some places are there. How many places are there? We can take the next places. But for the our example, we will take the last place is the 1000. In the 1000, which number is there? 6. So what is the place value of 6? 6000. Okay. But now, after the decimal point, these are the decimal fraction number. First of all, the first place is there, 10th. What is the first place? 10th. So what is the place value of 10 means 3? The 3/10. What is the place value of 3? 3/10. If you write in the proper fraction or common fraction, it is a 3/10. 100. Second place is there, 100. 100. So what is the place value of 7? 7/100. Okay. Next place, 1000. What is the next place? 1000. So what is the place value of 2? 2/1000. And the last digit is there, 8. So what is the place value of 8? 8/10,000. What is the place value of 8? 8/10,000. Okay. In the last period, sir has taught the two operations of decimal fraction. Sir has taught the two operations of decimal fraction. Sir already started this lesson. The addition of decimal fraction and the subtraction of decimal fraction. We will take the one example for the revision. First example. Add. Let's recall. First example, add. 416.34 or 34. Not we call it 34. 416.34 plus 63.45. So first of all, we will arrange this number in the columns or and then we will add. We will start from the right side, like the addition. There is no another rule for the addition in the decimal fraction. Same here, we will start from the right side and do the addition. 4 plus 5, 9. We know that. From the first standard, we had learned the addition. Now 3 plus 4, 7. Okay, 3 plus 4, 7. But after that, what is the decimal point is there? What is the decimal point? Or the below the decimal point, same here decimal point. And then in the sum of addition, we put the decimal point and the below. Means in the same row, we will put the decimal point here. Okay. So now our after decimal point, which addition is there, it is completed. Now the addition of whole number. So look at here. 6 plus 4, 10. So we have to add the 0 here. And what is the meaning? If the addition sum is the 10, 6 plus 4, 10 is there. So we have to add the 0 here. Now what is about the 1? 1 goes to carry. 1 goes to carry. Then we will take the 1 after 1 plus 1, 2, and then 2 plus 6, 8. Okay. Then here nothing is there, so we can put the 0 here. Or there's no need of 0, but for understanding, we can put the 0 here. 4 plus 0, 4. So our sum is there 480.79. What is sum of this example? 416.34 plus 63.45 is equal to 480.79. Okay. Now the next example, subtraction. First example of addition. Now the second example of subtraction. Same here. We will start from the right hand side. Which places are there? After the decimal point, two places are there, 10th and 100. So we will start from the 100th place. Which digits are there? 6 here and again 6 here. 6 minus 6, 0. Okay. Then 9 minus 8, 1 here. 9 minus 8, of course 1. Now the decimal point. Then it important of, means important point is there, our decimal point. So put the decimal point in the row of decimal point only. So here decimal point, again here decimal point. So we have to put the decimal point in the row of the decimal point. So after the decimal point, our whole number is there. So 6 minus 3. 6 minus 3, the difference between the 6 and 3, 3. 4 minus 7, is it possible? 4 minus 7? Of course not, because the 4 is smaller than 7. So we have to take the help from the 9. So 4 minus 7 not possible. So we have to cut this 4 from here and take the help from the 9. 1 means 110 here, means 14 make here. And how many remaining here? 8. So now 14 here. Now 14 minus 7, you know that. 14 minus 7, 7. Then 8 minus 6. So the difference or answer of this example, 946.96 minus 673.86 is equal to 273.10. What is the answer? 273.10. Now our next topic. Means we will start today this topic. It is new for you. Show the decimal fraction on number line. In the fraction also, we show the fraction on number line. Now here decimal fractions. How to show the decimal fractions on number line. In the last lecture, we had seen the example of scale. Now here, the sum units are there on the number line. 1 to 10 or 0 to 10. not 1 to 10, 0 to 10. So observe how the number line or how the numbers 0.7 and 6.5 are marked on the number line. यहाँ पे दिया है 0.7 और 6.5 हमने कैसे नंबर लाइन पे मार्क किए हैं. सो टेक द जीरो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आफ्टर जीरो टेक द सेवेंथ पार्ट और सेवेंथ पॉइंट फ्रॉम द जीरो बिफोर द वन. 0.7 मीन्स बिफोर द वन एंड आफ्टर द जीरो. सो गिवन इज देयर लॉन्ग लाइन इट इज द 0.7 हियर. ओके नाउ द 6.5 where is the 6.5 here. So we can count it after the 6. 6 is the whole number and 0.5 is the decimal number or decimal fraction. So after the count 6, fifth place or fifth small unit here. So 6.5 here. Now given some example are given there. In the same way show the following numbers on the number line. 3.5. 3 is the whole number and 5 is the decimal fraction number. So take the 3 first and after 3 take the small 5 units. Means here. Here 3.5 here. Now next example 0.8. Where we have to put the 0.8 before the 1 and after the 0. Before the 1 means 0.7. After the 0.7, we have to put the 0.8 here. Okay. 1.9. How to place the 1.9 or how to show the 1.9? 1 is the whole number. And after 1, we can take the 9 small place. So before the 2. Before the 2, one small line is there. It is here. 1.9 here. Okay. Now, 4.2. 4.2, after the 4, take the small 2 parts. 4 is the whole number and take the after 4, 2 parts here. 4.2 here. And put the red line there. Now 2.7 also same. After 2, take the 7th small part. So we can put here also. Or you can do in the homework also. Take the another example and you can do it in homework. Okay. Now the our important topic. How to convert the common fraction into the decimal fraction. It is an important topic for today. How to convert the common fraction into the decimal fraction. We know that our common fraction, 4/7, 2/3, these are the common fractions. So you know that if the denominator of common fraction is 10, 100 or 1000, I'm adding this one digit again, one number again. We know that in the denominator of common fraction, 10, 100 or 1000, it can be written as a decimal fraction. It can be written as the in the decimal fraction. So condition is there, some conditions are there. So we will see the conditions. If the denominator of common fraction is 10, 100 or 1000, then what we can do? So first of all, first condition is there. If there are more digits in the numerator than zeros in the denominator. अगर डिनोमिनेटर के जीरो से ज्यादा न्यूमरेटर के नंबर में ज्यादा डिजिट होंगे तो वी हैव टू काउंट द डिजिट्स हाउ मेनी डिजिट्स आर देयर एंड फ्रॉम द राइट साइड ऑफ द जीरोज वी हैव टू काउंट द जीरोज इन द डिनोमिनेटर एंड प्लेस द डेसिमल पॉइंट बिफोर दोज डिजिट्स. फिर हम उसको क्या करेंगे डेसिमल पॉइंट प्लेस करेंगे. सो लुक एट हियर first example is there 723 by 10. 723 by 10. Okay, so how many zeros are there? Only one zero is there. Don't count the one, count only zeros. How many zeros is there? One zero is there. So we have to write the 723 as it is and count the digits from the right side. How many zeros are there? One zero is there. So we have to count only one digit from the right side. One, after the put the decimal point here. Clear? One after the one digit from the right side. Three is there. After three, we have to put the decimal point in the this number. And this is the decimal fraction. 723 by 10 is equal to 72.3. Okay. Now the second example. 51,250 by 100. What is the second example? 51,250 by 100. Now, how many zeros are there in the 100? We know that 2 zeros are there. How many zeros are there? 2 zeros are there. So we have to write the 51,250 as it is, and count the digits from the right side. So we have to count the 2 zeros here in the denominator. So we have to count the 2 digits from the right side in the 51,250. 1, 2. Then put the decimal point here. So what is the answer? 512.50. What is the answer? 512.50. Next example. What is the next example? 5,138 by 1,000. See this example. 5,138 by 1,000 or upon 1,000. So how many zeros are there in the 1,000? 1, 2, 3 zeros are there. In the 1,000, we know that already 3 zeros are there. So we have to write the as it is 5,138 and count the digit from the right side. How many digits we have to count? 3 digits. Why? Because the 3 zeros in the denominator. So 1, 2, and 3. So put the decimal point here. Here? Here. Means what is the answer? 5.138. What is the answer? 5.138. Okay. Next condition. We'll see the next condition. Second condition. What is second condition? If there are as many digits in the numerator as zeros in the denominator. Agar numerator se denominator ke zeros ke barabar number honge ya phir usse kam honge. Hum next condition mein usse kam dekhenge, pehle yahan pe dekhenge. Agar denominator mein 1 zero hai to numerator mein 1 digit aayega. Denominator mein 2 zero hai to numerator mein 2 digit aayenge. Denominator mein 3 zero hai to numerator mein 3 digits आएंगे. So if there are the as many digits in the numerator as zeros in the denominator, place the decimal point before the number in the numerator and a zero in the integer's place. Look at here. 7 by 10. How many zeros are there? Only 1 zero. So what we have to do? Write the 7 and put the decimal point before the 7, and before the decimal point, what we have to write? 0. What we have to write? 0 here. Means 0.7. Means, agar denominator mein 1 zero hai, aur numerator mein 1 digit hai, toh hum kya karenge? Jo digit diya hai numerator mein, usko waise waise likh denge, aur uske aage decimal point likh denge. Aur jo integers ki place hai, ya phir whole number ki place hai, wahan pe kya put karenge? 0 put karenge. Okay, अभी सेकंड एग्जांपल देखो, 54 by 100. इन द 54 by 100, सो 2 zeros आर देयर, सेम हियर. हाउ मेनी डिजिट आर इन द 54? 2 digits आर देयर. सो इन द 54 वी हैव टू राइट द 54 एंड बिफोर द 54 पुट द डेसिमल पॉइंट एंड इन द इंटीजर प्लेस वी हैव टू राइट द 0. मींस 0.54 हियर. Look at this. Now the next example, 725 by 100. 1000. 725 by 1000. Same digits are there as a same zeros in the denominator. Three zeros in the denominator and the three digits in the 725 in the numerator. Okay. 725 by 1000. First of all, you can write the 725. Before the 725, we can put the zero for the decimal point. And before the decimal point, we can put the zero. Means our answer is the 0.725. Okay. Now the last condition. What is the last condition? If there are the fewer digits in the numerator than zeros in the denominator. अभी देखो अगर बहुत छोटा नंबर है डिनोमिनेटर के जीरो से अगर सपोज हमने यहाँ पे काउंट किए टू जीरो तो डिनोमिनेटर में कितने डिजिट है ओनली वन डिजिट है तो हम क्या करेंगे इसके लिए प्लेस द जीरो बिफोर द डिजिट इन द डिनोमिनेटर टू मेक द टोटल नंबर ऑफ डिजिट इक्वल टू द नंबर ऑफ जीरो इन द डिनोमिनेटर प्लेस द डेसिमल पॉइंट बिफोर देम एंड द जीरो इन द इंटीजर प्लेस अभी देखो यहाँ पे क्या दिया है अगर डिनोमिनेटर में ज्यादा जीरो है और न्यूमिनेटर में ओनली सिंगल या फिर डिनोमिनेटर के जीरो से बहुत कम डिजिट है तो क्या करेंगे तो अभी यहाँ पे दिए एग्जांपल देखो 8 by 100 यहाँ पे टू जीरो है और ऊपर ओनली वन डिजिट है तो हम क्या करेंगे ऊपर इक्वल करने के लिए बिफोर द 8 दे हैव पुट द 10 मीन्स एक्चुअली द वैल्यू ऑफ 08 इज द 8 The value of 08 is the 8. But we can write this for our understanding. So 08 means the 8. But is there two zeros? For these two zeros, for we have the right here 08. Now, as per this condition, we have to put the 0 here. After decimal point, and then we have to write the our remaining number. Means what is here? 0.08. Now look at here in the second example. 8 by 1000. 8 by 1000. How many zeros in the 1000? You know that 3 zeros are there. So in the decimal, in the numerator, we have to make the 3 digits. Already 3 digits are there. We have to put the 2 zeros before the 8. So this number is equal to the zeros of denominator. Then now as per this condition, second number condition, we have to do put the 0, then decimal point, and then write the remaining number. 0.008. What is the remaining part? 0.008. It is the third condition. Now we'll see the again some example in the practice set. First of all, we'll see the again second part. Now convert a decimal fraction into the common fraction. What we have to convert? Convert a decimal fraction. Before this topic, what we have taken? Convert the common fraction into the decimal fraction. But now here, decimal fraction into the common fraction. Decimal fraction, how to find the decimal fraction where the decimal point given is there. So it is the decimal fraction. Here, 26.4. So how to convert this decimal fraction in the common fraction? We know that count the zeros and then we can write the decimal fraction. Now look at here. In the decimal fraction, how many digits are there? Only one digit is there. So if the one digit is there, so denominator, how many zeros we have to write there? 10 right there. So write like this. Then write the number as it is. Means 26.4. How to write this 26.4? 264. Means what is the answer? 264.10. As per our first condition. Now look at here, 0.04 in the last condition is there. count the zeros in the decimal point. Okay, and put the decimal point here. So here 0.04. So how many digits after the decimal point? Two digits are there. So we will add the two zeros in the denominator after the one and write the number as it is in the numerator, like this, 4/100. Okay, in the last example, 19.315. So how many digits in the decimal section or after decimal point? Three digits are there. So we have to write the three zeros after one in the denominator and write the remaining number as it is. Means 19,315, like this. Okay, 19,315 by 1,000 is the answer of this third example. So what we had learned from these conditions, this is how we convert the decimal fraction into the common fraction. हम decimal fraction को common fraction में या फिर common fraction को decimal fraction में convert करने के लिए क्या करें? In the numerator, we write the number we get by the ignoring the decimal point. In the denominator, we write the one followed by as many zeros as there are the decimal places in the given number. Means जितने decimal point के बाद digit होते हैं उतने zeros हम one के बाद लिखते हैं in the denominator. Okay, one example, 43.06. How to convert this fraction into the common fraction? How many digits are there after the decimal point? Two digits are there. So we have to write the two zeros after the one, means what number in the denominator? 100. And write the remaining means number as it is, 4,306. What is the answer? 4,306/100. Okay. Now we will see the practice set. Practice set number 15. Three examples there in the practice set number 15. First example, write the proper number in the empty boxes. Second example, convert a common fraction into the decimal fraction. And the third question, convert the decimal fraction into the common fraction. We had already learned this, all this topic. So we will see the practice set one by one question. First question. It is already solved. You just look at here. Where the boxes are there, these are the empty boxes. So first question, write the proper number in the empty boxes. First question, 3/5. After the 3/5, already given is there 3/5, multiply in the denominator also. Same both here. But before this, already 10 given is there. This 2 and this 2 not given is there. This 10 is given there. So what we have to do, 5 multiply by 2 is equal to 10. So here we have to multiply the 2. This same number we have to multiply in the numerator also. If the in the denominator 2 multiply, so in the same denominator, so the numerator we have to multiply the 2. Means 3 multiply by 2 is equal to 6. Now our common fraction is the 6/10.
सर
हाँ यस
मुझे ये वाला सम
आता है ना ओके वेरी गुड नाउ जस्ट लुक एट हियर आई विल आस्क द क्वेश्चन आफ्टरवर्ड दैट टाइम यू विल गिव द आंसर ओके नाउ लुक एट हियर इन द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन 6/10 इज द प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन आफ्टर द प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन वी हैव टू कन्वर्ट इट इनटू द डेसिमल फ्रैक्शन How many zeros are there in the denominator? One zero is there. So after decimal point, how many digits are there? One. So what is the answer? 0.6. Okay. Means what we have to do here, 3 by 5 is there already. 3 by 5 multiply by empty box, after the multiply by empty box is equal to 6, sorry, in the numerator empty box is there, in the denominator 10 is there. So which number we have to multiply with the 3 and 5? So already 10 is there, so we have to multiply the 2 for making the 10 here. So 5 multiplied by 2 is equal to 10. So same digit we have to, or same number we have to multiply in the numerator also. 3 multiplied by 2 is equal to 6. So is equal to 6 by 10. Convert it to the decimal fraction. What is the answer? 0.6. Understand? Now second example. Some empty boxes are there. Already number 3 is there. So you ignore this number. 25 by 8. How to convert the 25 by 8 into the decimal fraction? So some numbers already given is there. In this denominator, 8 multiplied by 125 is there. So if the in denominator 8 multiplied by 25 is there, so in the numerator same numbers are there in the empty box, 125. So 25 multiplied by 125. What is the answer? 3125 by 1000. Means 25 multiplied by 125 is equal to 3125, and 8 multiplied by 125 is equal to 1000. So our common fraction is the 3125 by 1000. So in the 1000, how many zeros are there? 3 zeros are there. How many zeros are there? 3 zeros are there. So after decimal point, how many digits will be there? Three digits are there. So 3125 by 1000, convert into the decimal fraction, 3.125. Okay. Third one question, 21 by 2. What is the third question? 21 by 2. So both digits are, both numbers are there in the numerator and the denominator also, but after that empty boxes are there. Okay, same here. So but as the first question, here also same. In the denominator 10 is there. Okay, so 2 multiplied by 5 10. 2 multiplied by 5 is equal to 10. So if the 5 multiply here, in the numerator we have to multiply the 5. So 21 multiplied by 5 is equal to 105. So 105 by 10, convert into the decimal fraction. How to convert it? As per the count the zeros. So how many zeros are there in the denominator? Only one zero is there. So after a decimal point, we have to add the only one digit. Agar denominator mein one zero diya hai, so decimal point ke baad bhi ek hi digit aayega. So 105 by 10 is equal to 10 by 5. So 10.5. Okay. Now fourth question. What is the fourth question? 22 by 40. What is the fourth question? 22 by 40. Already they are converted this fraction, this common fraction, in the smaller unit. Means 11 by 20. Okay. Now 11 by 20. Same here. 11 multiplied by empty box given is there. Here empty box. And in the denominator 20 multiplied by 5. If the 20 multiplied by 5 is there, so we have to multiply the same digit or same number in the numerator also. So here 5 is in the multiplication, so we have to multiply the 5 in the numerator also. So 11 multiplied by 5 is equal to 55, and 20 multiplied by 5 is equal to 100. So it will be converted into the decimal fraction. So how many digits or how many zeros in the denominator? Denominator mein kitne zero hai? 2 zero hai. So yaha pe decimal point ke baad kitne digit aayenge? 2 digit aayenge. So अपने सेकंड कंडीशन के हिसाब से एज पर द सेकंड कंडीशन टू सेम डिजिट इन द सेम डिजिट इन द न्यूमरेटर एज पर द सेम जीरो इन द डिनोमिनेटर. सो टू जीरोस एंड टू डिजिट्स आर देयर. सो वी हैव टू राइट द जीरो, पुट द डेसिमल पॉइंट एंड राइट द नंबर एज इट इज 0.55. ओके, इट इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. If you have a problem, I will see after the complete topic. Okay. Now the second question. What is the second question? Convert the common fraction into the decimal fraction. We had seen this in the, our topic. Convert the common fraction into the decimal fraction. First of all, 3/4. First example is there. 3/4 in the practice sheet. So 3/4 convert into the decimal fraction. So first of all, 3/4, which number we have in the denominator? 10, 100 or zeros. Which number we have the in the denominator? 10, 100 or 1000 for the decimal fraction. So first of all, 3/4, so we have to multiply the denominator like this number which had make the 10,000 or 100 in the denominator. So 4 here. So we have to multiply the 4 by 25. 4 multiplied by 25, 100. Okay. If the 25 multiply in the denominator, the same 25 multiply in the numerator also. Okay. 4 multiplied by 25 is equal to 100. So 3 multiplied by 25 is equal to 75. Okay. 3 multiplied by 25 is equal to 75. Now we can convert this common fraction into the decimal fraction. How many zeros are there in the denominator? 2 zeros are there. So we have to put the 2 digits after the decimal point and write the 0 into the on the integer place, means 0.75. Okay. Now, second example, 4 upon 5. So same here, convert the denominator into 10,000 or 100 unit. So 5 here, 5 multiplied by 2, we know that 5 multiplied by 2 is equal to 10. If the 2 multiply by in the denominator, the same 2 multiply in the numerator also. So 5 multiplied by 2 is equal to 10. So 4 multiplied by 2 is equal to 8. So we get the common fraction 8 by 10. Now 8 by 10 convert into the decimal fraction. So 10 is there. After the decimal point, we want the only one number or one digit. Only one digit in the numerator also. Same with the numerator and the denominator. Same digits are there as the zeros. So 0.8 answer is there. In the third question, 9/8. So 8 in the previous question, look at here. Look at it. 8/125 given is there. Okay. So we have to multiply the 8 with the 25. So for the making the 1000. 8 multiplied by 25. 125. 8 multiplied by 125 is equal to 1000. So if the 125 multiply in the denominator, say 125 multiply in the numerator also. So 9 multiply by 125. So find the product. 9 multiply by 125 is equal to 1125. And in the denominator, 8 multiply by 125 is equal to 1000. So now we can make this common fraction into the decimal fraction. So we get this answer, 1.125. Okay. How to get this answer? As a counter, zeros. How many zeros are there? 3 zeros are there. And after the decimal point, we want the 3 digits. So that's why 3 zeros are there. Now then, next question. 7 questions are there. We'll see the one by one. Fourth number, 17/20. What is the fourth question? 17/20. Look at here. if we multiply the 5 with the 20, so we will get the 100. So here 20 multiplied by 5 is equal to 100. So same 5 multiply in the numerator. 17 multiplied by 5 is equal to 85. So 85 by 100. What is our answer? 85 by 100 in the common fraction. Now we have to convert in the common fraction. This common fraction is the decimal fraction. अभी हमें आपसे आंसर मिल गया है 85 by 100. तो अभी इसको हम कॉमन फ्रैक्शन डेसिमल फ्रैक्शन में कन्वर्ट करेंगे. तो उसके लिए हम क्या करते हैं, जीरोस काउंट करते हैं. हाउ मेनी जीरोस आर देयर? टू जीरोस आर देयर इन द डिनोमिनेटर. अभी टू जीरोस दिए तो क्या करेंगे, आफ्टर डेसिमल पॉइंट ऑलरेडी जो डिनोमिनेटर है उसमें टू ही डिजिट है, तो हम क्या करेंगे 0.085, क्योंकि हमें आफ्टर डेसिमल पॉइंट टू डिजिट चाहिए. तो जो नंबर दिए उसको वैसे की वैसे लिख देंगे, उसके पहले डेसिमल पॉइंट और उसके पहले उसके उसके पहले जीरो लिख देंगे. ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 देखो. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 क्या है, 36/40. व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5? 36/40. अभी उसको उन्होंने उसको हम स्मॉल यूनिट में कर देंगे. अगर हमने 36 को और 40 को सेम नंबर से डिवाइड किया तो हमें मिलता है 9/40. जैसे कि 9 4 9 36 और 4 10 40. 4 से अगर डिवाइड किया दोनों को तो हमें 9/10 मिलेगा. देखो 36/4 = 9 और 40/10 और 40/4 तो हमें मिलेगा 10. तो हमने उसको स्मॉलर यूनिट में कर लिया है और उसकी वैल्यू कम कर ली है. यूनिट जो फ्रैक्शन है वो सेम है, इक्वल फ्रैक्शन है, लेकिन उसकी वैल्यू हमने कम कर ली क्योंकि हमें डिनोमिनेटर में 10, 100 या 1000 चाहिए, इसलिए हमने उसको ऐसी कर ली. सो नाउ वी कैन कन्वर्ट दिस कॉमन फ्रैक्शन इनटू द डेसिमल फ्रैक्शन. सो फॉर दैट व्हाट वी कैन डू हियर, हाउ मेनी जीरो इज इन द डिनोमिनेटर? ओनली 1 0. सो सेम हियर एज पर द सेकंड कंडीशन ऑफ दिस टॉपिक. सो 0.9 इसका आंसर आएगा. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन नंबर 6? 7/25. व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन नंबर 6? 7/25. सेम हियर 20. इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई द 4 विद द 25 यू विल गेट द 100. यू विल गेट द प्रोडक्ट 100. सो इन द डिनोमिनेटर वी वांट 10, 100 or 1000 for the decimal fraction. So we have to make the 100 here with the multiply by 4 with 25. 25 multiplied by 4 is equal to 100. If the multiply the 4 in the denominator, same 4 multiply in the numerator also. 7 multiplied by 4 is equal to 28. 7 4 are 28 hota hai. So 28/100. Now we can convert it. How many zeros are there? 2 zeros are there. So after 2 zeros means after the decimal point, we were under 2 places and only 2 digits are there. So 0.28. Our last example of second question. 19 by 200. Now here 19 is a odd number, so we cannot do the less of this fraction value. So 19/200, so it will be converted into the 200 into the 1000. If you multiply the 5 with 200, we can get the 1000, and the same 5 we will multiply in the numerator also. So 19/5 is equal to 95, and 200/5 is equal to 1000. So now here how many zeros in the denominator? 3 zeros is there. So we have to write the 95 like this, 0.95/1000. So 3 zeros are there and 3 digits are there. Same. Okay. Numerator and denominator also. The 3 digits in the numerator and the 3 zeros in the denominator. So now, as per the second condition, we can do now. 0.9 0.095. Okay, what is the answer? 0.095. Now the last question of practice set, question number third. Convert the decimal fraction into the common fraction. Last topic is there. Our last example question is there. Convert a decimal fraction into the common fraction. First question, 27.5. So look at here. After decimal point, how many digits are there? One digit. So we have 2 1 0 in the denominator and write the zero as follow the our condition. And now write the, our given number as it is. So we have to write the 275. Our answer is the 275/10. Okay. Now second question. 0.007. Our second question is there. 0.007. So how many digits after the decimal point? We know that 3 digits are there. This 7, this 0 and 0. So we have to put the 3 zeros after the 1 in the denominator and write the given number as it is. 7 is there. So 7/1000 our answer. Third question. I will listen your questions after the this question. So you have to prepare your question. Okay. Third one, 90.8. What is the third one question? 90.8. How many digits are there after decimal point? Only one digit. So we have to 10 after the 1 in the denominator and write the given number as it is. Remove the decimal point from here. 908. Okay, look at 90.8. How to convert the 90.8 into the common fraction? We have to put the 10 after 1 in the denominator and write the number as it is in the numerator. Okay, now next fourth one question. 39.15. Okay, 39.15. So how many digits after the decimal point? 2, 1 and 5. 2 digits are there in the after decimal point. So we have to put the 2 zeros in the denominator and write the number as it is as remove the decimal point. So 3915. What is the answer? 3915. Okay. Now the last question. Fifth question. 3.12. Convert into the common fraction. How many digits are there in the after decimal? 2 digits are there. So we have to write the 2 zeros after the 1 in the denominator and write the same means given number as it is. Remove the decimal point. मतलब अभी यहाँ पे यहाँ का जो decimal point दिया है वो remove कर देंगे और जो number दिया उसको as it is लिख देंगे. 312. It is a practice sheet number 15. Here completed. Now you can take the homework. You can take the screenshot of this homework. And now if you have the any question you can ask.
Eight, raise your hands, please.
Student, if you have any question, you can ask me.
Eight's
adding. I think you have no problem or not any doubt.
Okay, sir, can you put option there?
take the screenshot of this homework and complete it. Student, take the screenshot of this homework.
Yes, sir. I take the screenshot of this.
Okay. Now you understand all these topics?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good. Can I stop now?
Okay, sir.
Okay, bye.
Bye, sir. Bye.
Thank you very much. Thank you.